Hi, welcome to a product tutorial by Robojax. In this video, we are going to learn how we can use this volt ampere meter that can measure up to 10 ampere, 100 volts that is sold on eBay and Amazon. We're going to see how we can measure the current and voltage with this. Then I'm going to show you if the voltage and current is not accurate, how to adjust and fix it through this shunt resistor. This wire is a shunt resistor. And we have some voltage drop proportionally to the current. Measure the voltage and see how much is that voltage. Let's get started with this. This can measure the voltage up to 100 volts, and in terms of current, it can go up to 10 ampere. So this is compact and it's taking very less space. And it can be installed in boxes for any purpose that you have. This is one of the VA meter, volt and ampere meter, that is sold on Amazon and eBay website, and it shows around $2.84, or on Amazon for about $10 plus shipping. And there are different colors, as you can see here. This is red and green. We can see green and blue, and also it has a label here, DC, but all of these are the same. When you receive the package, they will put it in a bag, something like this. We have two wires here, this portion, and there is a thick wire. This can measure up to 10 ampere. So how it works is that this needs voltage to operate first, that you have to know it, that it needs its own voltage regardless of what it does. And then to display the voltage of something, then you need to connect the different wire, and to display the current, you need to connect different wires. These two work together. You can display the voltage, or you can display the current and the voltage of the same power that is used for the current. So they are not independent. You might get it with the red, black and white, or red, black and yellow. In both cases, red and black is the main power to power this up, and the yellow is to measure the voltage and display it on the screen. When you connect it to the red and black, it just powers this up. You will connect always these two main wires that are on the left side, red and black, to power this up. To measure the voltage, we will connect this. For the current, there is a thick wire because it measures up to 10 ampere. If you're using longer wire, make sure to use very thick wire. They've used here 18 gauge wire. There, you see, this is a shunt resistor here, the thick wire. When you connect it, the current comes, passes through this resistor and goes back, and then the voltage that drops here, very little voltage, will be amplified and displayed as a current on the screen. The length is 44.9 millimeter by 26 millimeter, and the depth for the frame is 17.3 millimeter. To see how much space we got, 36 millimeter. Now to do the test, I will first apply voltage to this. This is my power source that I'm supplying, something above 5 volts, up to 30 volts, doesn't matter, to make this active. By connecting the negative to the negative and positive to the positive. And as you can see, now it's on. Now to display the current, I'm measuring a current. This is 1 ohm 50 watt resistor. The accuracy of this one is, the tolerance is 10%, so it goes up and down, but for us it's okay. To understand how we measure the current, let me explain this. We have a battery and we have a load. The load has two terminal, positive negative, and our battery has positive negative. Positive will be connected to the positive of the load from the battery. Also the negative will be connected to the negative. Now, in order to connect and measure the current, only for the current, we can connect it the ammeter, any ammeter that you have, either this way, that in between the, in the path of the current, you can put it like this, either on the negative wire side, or you can put it on the positive wire side. Doesn't matter, you can put your ammeter to display the current. But because this can display the voltage, and if you want to measure the same voltage of the current that you're measuring, then you have to put it this way, meaning that this has a red wire. The red wire will be on the negative side of the load, and the positive of the load will be connected to the positive, and the negative of the ammeter will go to the negative of the power. So positive goes to the load, and then from this side it exits. Now this will be positive because it sees the battery, and it enters the ammeter and it exits, and the circuit is completed by going to the negative. This is my battery. Normally if I want it connected to the load, it doesn't have any positive or negative because this is just a load. You will just connect it like that and the current will pass. Right now it's around 6 amperes passing through this with the voltage that I have. I will connect the positive from my battery to the load, and then from the negative I will connect it to my ammeter. So positive to the load. Let me plug this in. Now this positive will be connected to the load. I have here a cable connecting it and connecting the positive in here. Negative is hanging. Let me connect this. Let me put this so you can see it. And now I connect it here. And as you can see, we are reading the current, but we are not reading the voltage. The reason for that is that this wire is hanging. To read the voltage, I have to connect the yellow to the positive. Doesn't matter battery or load, it's the same wire. And if I put this here, you will see that I'm reading the voltage at 6.9 volts. Let me use this wire so it's holding it for me. Right now the current is not connected, that's why we can read only the voltage and not the current. I'm connecting it now, and as you can see, we are reading the current. The voltage is 10.8. Now input voltage is 6 volts. Let me increase it. You see the current. Let me reduce it, then go to the lowest that even I can go, 0.5 and 0.1. Even at 0.1 volt you can read it. The reason for that is that this voltage is already between 5 to 30 volts, so it has main logic power to operate. 0.1 volt is the voltage of the battery or the power supply that we are measuring for the resistor or load, and it shows 0.13 ampere. This might not be accurate, so I'm going to test it next. If your input voltage for the load is between 5 to 30 volt, then you don't need external power. Let's say you have 7.3 volts for this power. In that case, you can connect this directly to the same power. Connect the yellow and red together, twist them. Now the voltage that is supplied and the voltage that is displayed is the same, and this is the negative. I'm connecting negative to the negative. I'm going to connect these two wires that is twisted together to this positive. Now the meter is ready. I need to connect this to this, and as you can see, it shows the Now input voltage is the same as the operating voltage of this one, and if I go between 5 to 30 volts, this simply works fine. But here is a problem: if this power is less than 5 volts, this will shut off. Let's see at what voltage it will shut off. 6 volts, 5.3, 4. Nice. Let's wait. 3.6. Now it's getting dimmer. You see, so 3.6 still is good. I've spent quite some time testing this and preparing, editing, and uploading this video so you can use it easily. The least that you can do for me is to hit the subscribe button and leave the notification on. It's really appreciated. This is the electronic load DL3031, and these are the two terminals that from the circuit will be connected in here, and we will see the voltage here and the current. I've connected it now to electronic load. The voltage that is here, you can see it in here, and the current we will see here and we will read it here. And I can set the current here. For example, this is at the moment 5 ampere. Turn it on. This 5 ampere is now displayed here, and we can see 3.2, that's 3.4 volts. The voltage is displayed. Let me increase the current. 6 amp, I increase it to 6. 7 ampere, you can read it in here, that's the accurate one. 8, 9, as you can see, 8, 9. And now we are at 10 ampere, 9.99. And let me increase the voltage. And here you can see this is the voltage that we are reading, and that is the voltage is displayed, the original one. So 6 ampere is being drawn, and we can see the voltage. Do not worry why the current is constant, because I've used here CC, constant current. The job of this electronic load is to keep the current constant. Let me make some changes at the decimal point. So it's 5.7 here, we are reading 5.7. Input voltage is 0.6 volts and the current is 0.23, 230 milli. Ampere. Let me show you inside this, because this is very thick. I can do that, just pull it from here. The current, the voltage is still there. Let me just connect the, so we can see that the current is going on. Source comes here from the positive to this point, and from here it goes through this shunt resistor. This wire is a shunt resistor, and from this point it goes to this and exits. So the whole point is that it comes and it passes, and we have some voltage drop proportionally to the current. Now let's measure the voltage and see how much is that voltage. It's 10 ampere exactly, and it shows 9.96. let's measure the voltage here across this. 48.7 millivolts. So I put it on hold. Now we have 10 ampere passing through this resistor, and by Ohm's law we can see R is equal V over I, and that's the voltage, 0.0487. that is 48.7 millivolts divided by 10 ampere, and you can see that this is 4.87 milliohm, 0.0487. so this is 48.7 milliohm resistor. Perhaps it might be 50, I don't know. 48.7 milliohm. That's very accurate. Now I'm going to show you if the voltage or current that you're reading is not accurate, how you can adjust it. You need to first trusted source. This is very accurate, this electronic load. And here we have two potentiometer. One is here, it says adjust ADJI, and this one ADJV. So this is for voltage, this potentiometer. You need a flat screwdriver, and this is for the current. A little, there is some difference in design. For example, this display chip is in the same position. The voltmeter that is here, in this case, it has been between these two. And then voltage regulator is in here, but on this one, it's on the other side. But the two potentiometer, this is voltage adjust is located here, and then current adjust, I adjust is located here. This one they call it adjust I and adjust. So and there is a model printed on this one, does not, doesn't matter because it's the same chip. This is the current. I'm gonna rotate it to see. Now let's adjust the voltage as well. 3.5, and then let me go to the right clockwise. It's fully clockwise. This way you can adjust the voltage and current to get accurate value. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this volt ampere meter. If you learned something, please thumb up. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And do not forget to subscribe. Thank you.